Hello students, welcome back to maths class. In this video we will see exercise 8.2 of class 6th. So let's begin the exercise. Its first question is complete the table with the help of these boxes and use decimals to write the number. In this question we have A, B and C part. From these boxes we have to fill this table. In the first one you can see we have one box and we have the parts of box. So firstly we will see how many total parts are here. So firstly we will count the horizontal number of boxes. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So here we have 10 boxes. Here vertical we will see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here we have 10. You can see same sizes are all the way. So if we are taking here the total number of boxes, total number of part is here, same number of part will be here. So 10 into 10, 10 into 10 is 100. It means in the one box we have 100 parts. Okay, now let's count it. So this is the total number of parts are 100. Okay, total number of parts are 100, but how many are filled? Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10, 10, 20, 21, 23, 24, 25, 26. Okay. 26 are filled. 26 are filled out of 100 because total are 100. So, when we see 8, this is the fraction part of the box and we have to write it into the decimal part. Here in the denominator we have two zeros. It means from the right hand side we can leave two places, two values, and we have to put decimal. Now we don't have any value on the place of ones, so we have to put here zero. So what number we will get? We get 0.26. Here on the ones place we have 0, on the 10th place we have 2, and on the 100th place we have 6. So this is the first part. Now B part. In the B part we have one box fulfilled by 100. Okay, all are 100 and total 100 part is here. Okay, now we will count here. This is 10, this is also 10. Okay, here also 10. Now count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Here we have 8. So 10, 20, 30, and this is 38. This 38 is out of 100. Okay, so both are of the B, so we can add 100 plus 38. Okay, and both are having same denominator, so it will be 138 by 100. Now in the denominator 100 is having two zeros, so we can leave two values from the right hand side, that is 8 and 3. Now decimal will come, now 1. So B is 1.38. On the ones place we have 1, on the 10th place we have 3, and on the 100th place we have 8. C is same as it is. Here we have 100, so this is total are 100 out of 100. Now second part of the C we will count. This is 10. Here we have 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Here we have 8. सो टोटल इज़ हेयर 28. सो 128, 128 विल गिव अस 128 आउट ऑफ 100. सो आफ्टर लीविंग टू वैल्यूज फ्रॉम द राइट हैंड साइड दैट इज 8 एंड 2, वी विल पुट डेसिमल एंड 1 विल कम. सो सी आंसर इज 1.28. ओके, सो वंस वैल्यू इज 1, टेंथ्स प्लेस इज 2 एंड हंड्रेड्स वैल्यू इज 8. यू नो इन बिटवीन वंस एंड टेंथ डेसिमल विल बी हियर. सो दिस इज द कंप्लीशन ऑफ फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. नाउ सेकेंड क्वेश्चन. सेकेंड क्वेश्चन इज राइट द नंबर्स गिवन इन द फॉलोइंग प्लेस वैल्यू टेबल इन डेसिमल फॉर्म. सो सिंपली वी हैव टू राइट द डेसिमल फॉर्म ऑफ द गिवन वैल्यूज विच इज गिवन इन द प्लेस वैल्यू टेबल. सो इन द प्लेस वैल्यू टेबल वी हैव वंस, टेंस, हंड्रेड्स एंड हेयर टेंथ, हंड्रेड्स, थाउजेंड्स. सो फ्रॉम वेयर वी हैव टू पुट द डेसिमल? वी ऑलवेज डेसिमल विल कम इन बिटवीन वंस एंड टेंथ्स. ओके, सो हेयर वी हैव डेसिमल बिकॉज व्हेन वी मल्टीप्लाई, लाइक इन द ए वन व्हेन वी मल्टीप्लाई 2 by 1 by 10, सो इट विल बी 2 by 10 एंड 10. इट मीन्स फ्रॉम लीविंग वन वैल्यू ऑफ फ्रॉम राइट हैंड साइड वी विल पुट हियर डेसिमल. सो इट्स वैल्यू विल बी 2.0.2. ओके, नाउ डेसिमल विल बी कम हियर, सेम एज इट इज विल बी गोइंग ऑन. सो व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑन द प्लेस ऑफ वंस? वी हैव 3. ऑन द प्लेस ऑफ टेंस वी हैव 0. ऑन द प्लेस ऑफ हंड्रेड्स वी हैव 0. नाउ डेसिमल विल कम आफ्टर द 3. 3 विल बी हियर, डेसिमल विल बी हियर. नाउ टेंथ्स प्लेस इज 2, हंड्रेड्स प्लेस इज 5 एंड थाउजेंड्स प्लेस इज 0. इट कैन बी ऑल्सो राइट इन द फॉर्म बिकॉज इन फ्रंट ऑफ एनी नंबर इफ वी हैव नंबर्स ऑफ 0, सो इट डज नॉट मीन. सो वी कैन राइट हियर 3.25 एंड इफ इन द लास्ट ऑफ द 0 ऑफ डेसिमल वैल्यू वी हैव 0, सो वी कैन निगलेक्ट दैम. ओके, नाउ बी इज हंड्रेड्स प्लेस इज 1, टेंथ्स प्लेस इज 0, वंस प्लेस इज 2. नाउ वॉट विल कम हियर? डेसिमल. नाउ टेंथ्स प्लेस इज 6, हंड्रेड्स प्लेस इज 3 एंड थाउजेंड्स प्लेस इज 0. सो यू कैन नो वी कैन इग्नोर द लास्ट 0 ऑफ डेसिमल वैल्यू. सो इट्स विल बी 1.102.63. नाउ सी इज हंड्रेड प्लेस इज 0, टेंस प्लेस इज 3, वंस प्लेस इज 0. नाउ वॉट विल कम हियर? डेसिमल. टेंथ्स प्लेस इज 0, हंड्रेड्स प्लेस इज 2 एंड थाउजेंड्स प्लेस इज 5. नाउ विच 0 वी कैन निगलेक्ट? वी कैन निगलेक्ट द वेरी फर्स्ट 0 ऑफ द नंबर. सो इट विल बी 30.025 विल बी सेम बिकॉज 0 इन द डेसिमल इज कमिंग इन बिटवीन द नंबर, नॉट एट द एंड. नाउ डी पार्ट इज हेयर, 100 इज 2, टेंस इज 1, वंस इज 1. नाउ डेसिमल, टेंथ्स इज 9, हंड्रेड इज 0, थाउजेंथ इज 2. बट दिस नंबर विल बी रिमेन सेम बिकॉज एट इन द फ्रंट ऑफ द नंबर वी डोंट हैव एनी 0 एंड एट द एंड ऑफ द डेसिमल वैल्यू वी डोंट हैव 0. सो सेम विल बी हेयर. नाउ लास्ट ई इज, इट्स हंड्रेड्स इज 0, tens is 1, ones is 2, now decimal will come, tenths is 2, hundredth is 4, and thousandths is 1. Now in the front of number we have 0, so we can ignore this 0, so it will be 12.241. This is the solution of second question. Question number 3 now is, write the following decimals in the place value table. So given A, B, C, D part is here, we have to fill these values in the place value table. That's why I already make here table which is containing ones, tens, hundred, and tens, hundredths, thousandths. Okay, now you have to know we have to put the decimal. Decimal will always come in between ones and tenths. Okay, so decimal will be here. Okay, now its A part is 0.29. So just before the decimal we have ones place, so ones place is 0, and just after the decimal we have tenth place is 2, and after 2 we have 9, which is on the hundredths place. Now other are blank, so we can put here 0. Okay, in between we don't able to put 0 by our side, but in front of the number and at the end of the decimal value we can put 0. Now B is 2.08. just before the decimal value we have ones place, so 2 will be go here on the ones place. After the decimal, first value is tenths, so 0 will be here, and 8 is on the hundredths place. Okay, now remaining blank boxes will filled by 0. Same is here we have 19.60. just before the decimal we have ones place, so 9 will go on the ones place. Before the 9 we have 1, so 1 will come here. After the decimal value just 10th place will come, and 10th place is 6, and after the 6 hundredths place, so 0 will be come on here. Now blank boxes will filled by zeros. D is 148.32. just before the decimal we have ones place, so 8 will go on the ones place. 8 will be here. Before 8 we have 4, and before 4 we have 1, as you can see. Just after the decimal we have first value which is on the place of 10th, so 3 will be go on the tenths place, and 2 will go on the hundredths place, and the blank box will filled by 0. Now E is 200.812. just before the decimal ones place, and ones place is having 0, so 0 before this 0 we have 0, and before this 0 we have 2, and just after the decimal we have 10th place, so 8 will be go on the 10th place. After the 8 we have 1, and after the 1 we have 2. So this is the solution of third question. Let's see fourth number question. Question number 4, write each of the following as decimals. Okay, so here we have the expanded form of the decimal, we have to write it into the decimal form. Now here if I hide only this much part, so 20 plus 9 is 29. Okay, 20 plus 9 is 29. Now what will be the value of these two? You can see here we have 4 by 10, 1/100. So if I remove this zero, so this zero will put the decimal after leaving one value, because 10 after leaving one value it will put decimal, and here in the 100 we have two zeros, so it will leave two values, so 1 and 0 and decimal. Okay, so we can add them. So what will be the value? Here we have 4, here we have 0 1, so 0 1. When we add them, 1 as it is, 4 plus 0 is 4 and decimal. So what will come after 29? After 29 we have 0.41. okay, now B is 137. So 137 will be same. Now you can see here we don't have 10th value, we don't have any value which is representing 10th part of anything. We have directly 5/100, it means this is the 100th part. So after putting decimal we have to put 0, because we don't have 10th part of anything. Now this is the 5, so what will be the value of 5/100? It will be 5 and 0 point. Okay, so is it 0 is coming here? Yes, 0 is coming here, that's why 5 will be same. Okay, you can see after leaving 2 0 decimal is coming. Yes, after leaving 2 values, 1 2 decimal will be here. So this is the answer of B. C is 23. So 23 will be same. Now here we have 2/10. So after leaving one value we have to put decimal, and here we have 6/1000. 6/1000, it means we have to leave 1 2 3 places. So first place will be 6, second place will be 0, third place will be 0. Okay, then we have to put decimal. Here we have only one value, that's why by our side we have to put extra zeros for putting decimal. Now we will add them. Okay, so decimal 2, after decimal same decimal will come here, 0 0 6. 0 0 6. Now we can add them. 6 is here, 0 is here, and 2 plus 0 is 2. Now you can see on the place of hundredths we have 0, because we don't have any value, we don't have any value which is showing the part of 100. It means we did correctly. So its answer will be 23.206. D is 700 plus 20 plus 5. When you add this starting 3, you will get 725. Now you can see we don't have any value which is representing 10th part. So what will be the value of this? Here we have 100, and 100 is having 2 zeros. So we have to leave 2 values. First value will be 9, and second value will become as 0. Now we can put here decimal. So after 725 decimal, 0 9, we don't have any 10th part of anything, that's why 0 will be here. So here is the total solution of question number 4. Now we will see question number 5. Question number 9 is, write each of the following decimals in word. So simply that we are pronouncing the values, same we have to write here in the words. But most of the students are doing same kind of mistake. They are writing after the decimal value as it is. They are simply writing it is 20, 19, 66, 92, 57. That is absolutely wrong. Here, after the decimal, we have to pronounce digit by digit. As you can see, here we have 0.03. So its answer will be 0.03. Second will be 1.20. 1.20. Third will be 0.19. So 0.19. D is 0.66. It will be 0.66. E is 0.92. 0.92. F is 0.57. 0.57. So this is the complete solution of question number 5. Now question number 6 is, between which two numbers in 10th place on the number line does each of the given number lie? So we have 6 sub question. We have to show which two numbers the given question will be lie. It means 4 is coming in between which two numbers? So before 4, 3, and after 4, 5. So we have to find these two numbers. But we have to represent its 10th place. 10th place we have to represent. So as it is, we will solve. First, A is 0.06. We have to represent this number. This 0.6 will come on which two numbers? In between which two numbers this 0.6 will come, but on the 10th place. So first place will be same. Okay, you can consider is 6 is coming in between which number? 6 is coming in between 0 to 10. But we have to represent only 10th value, so this 1 will come only. Okay, so its answer will be 0 and 1. But here we have 0.06, so same 0.0 and here 0.1. We have to represent 10th place, so only 10th place will come. Now here we have 0.45. So you can consider this 45 as 45. So 45 is coming between which two number? 45 is coming between 40 and 50. But we will just only show 4 and 5. 4 and 5. So how it will be right? It will be right as 0.4 and 0.5. okay, because the given question is asking for the 10th place, so this 4 and 5 will go on the 10th place. Okay, now C is 0.19. so this 19 will be considered as 19, and 19 is coming in between 10 to 20. So we can neglect this 0 zeros. So it will be 0.1 and 0.2, because we have to represent only 10th place, that's why we are neglecting 0 zeros. Now D is 0.66, so it will be considered as 66. So 66 is coming in between 60 to 70. 10th place we have to show, so that's why we are ignoring this 0 zeros. So its answer will be 0.6 and 0.7. okay, now here we have 92. Okay, so 92 is coming in between 90 to 100. Okay, so in this one thing is here we have to ignore the last zero. So here we have 0 will be ignored, and here will be 0 will be ignored. Okay, so what will be here? First number will be 0.9. But here next number, what will become here? Next number will be here. We have to write it in the form of after leaving. You can see in the previous, just before the 7 we have to put decimal. So just by leaving, okay, just by leaving this 0 we have to put here decimal. Here we have 7, that's why after leaving 7 we have to put decimal, after leaving 1 value. So same, after leaving 1 value we have to put decimal. So its answer will be 1.0. Now f is 0.57. here 57 is come in between 50 and 60. Last value we will ignore because 10th place we have to show. So its answer will be 0.5 and 0.6. So 0.57 will come in between 0.5 and 0.6 on the place of 10th place. Now question number 7 is write as fraction in lowest term. So here we have to represent this 0.60 in the lowest term. So we have given question is 0.60. You can see after the decimal we have 1, 2 values. So when I remove the decimal, 2 zeros will come with the having 1. So it will be 100. So you can cut. Here we have 60 by 100. Both are coming in the table of 10, that's why we are dividing numerator and denominator both by 10. When 60 will divide by 10, it will be 6, and when 100 will divide by 10, it will be 10. Now once again you can see they both are coming in the table of 2, so they both are dividing by 2. When 6 is dividing by 2, it will be 3, and when 10 will divide by 2, it will be 5. So this is the solution of A. B is, we have 0.05. So question is 0.05. You can see after the decimal we have 1, 2 values. So when we remove the decimal, 2 zeros will come with 1. So here we have 100. So it will be 5 by 100. You can see they both can be divided by 5. So numerator and denominator both will divide by 5. When 5 will divide by 5, it will give 1. And when 100 will divide by 5, so 5 twos are 10. And the last 0 will be as it is. So its lowest form 1 by 20. C is 0.75. After the decimal 2 values, so when we remove this decimal, 2 zeros will come with 1. Now we have 75 by 100. You can see they both can be divided by 25 as well as 5. So directly we can divide by 25, but when we are dividing it by the 5, we have to divide 2 times by 5, as 5, I am solving with 5. So what will be 5? When 5 will divide 7, it will give 1. So carry will go near to 5, 2. So it will be 25. And 25 will divide by 5, 5 times. Okay. Now here, when 100 will divide by 5, it will give us 20. Now I already explained, when in the case of 5, we have to divide by 2 times 5. Okay, so one time already, and you can see 15 and 20 also divide by 5 one more time. If we are dividing it by 25 directly, so only one time will be sufficient. Okay, 15 is coming in the table of 5 3 times, and 20 will go 4 times. So this is the final answer of 0.75, lowest fraction of decimal. D is 0.18. So 0.18. after decimal 1, 2 values. So when we remove the decimal, 2 zeros will come with 1. So here we have 18 by 100. Now both are even, so they can be easily divided by 2. Okay, so 18 is coming in the table of 2 9 times, and 100 will go from the table of 2 50 times, and 9 and 50 will be the lowest form of 0.18 because it will not divide by same table numerator and denominator. E is 0.125. So after the decimal, as you can see, 1, 2, 3 values. So when we remove the decimal, 1, 2, 3 zeros will come with 1. So directly it can be divided by 5, 25 and 125. By these three tables, we can divide them. Okay. So we are starting with the 5. Okay. So 125 when divided by 5, and same 1000 will also divide by 5. Okay. So it's when 125 will divide by 5, it will give us 25. Okay. And when 1000 will divide by 5, it will give us 200. Okay. Now you can see 25 and 200 both can be directly divided by 25. So when 25 will divide by 25, it will give 1, and when 200 will divide by 25, it will give 8. So this is the lowest form of the decimal in the fraction. Now F is 0.066. 0.066. After the decimal, 1, 2, 3 values. So when we remove the decimal, 3 zeros will come with 1. So what is the fraction? Is 66 by 1000. Both are even, so they can divide by 2. Okay, so when 66 will divide by 2, it will give us 33, and when 1000 will divide by 2, it will give us 500. Now numerator is odd and denominator is even, so this is the lowest form of the decimal in fraction. So here we completed our exercise. I hope you understood properly. Thank you.